Right guys, it is day 5 and we've just come out of Drew Steinton and we're walking past Peter Randall's house and that. What's his?
Peter Randall Page.
Yeah, I thought it was. Yeah, I didn't want to butcher it. Yeah, so I've been looking out for this sculpture. So this is Peter Randall Page's sculpture. The other half is just on the start of Exmoor and it just bridges the gap between the Devon stage. Yeah, I've been seeing this a lot in books and that, and yeah, it's great to finally actually see it. But yeah, we almost missed it. Yeah, very aged now. Right, anyway, we're going to head up that way now. And I'll catch you guys later on. We're going to head to Mortchard Bishop, which is about 14 miles. There's a campsite there, so we'll probably stay there. But if we get there a bit early, we may push on a bit more. Anyway, catch you guys later on. Cheers. Action! First of many styles today. Yeah. Oh, there's another one down there. So that's the third one so far today, I believe. Beautiful day. Alright, catch you folks later on. Cheers. Hey guys, so we've just come through the village of Hitsley. And yeah, we're about 3 miles in. Had quite a bit of a difficulty for a field just now. Signage was crap and yeah, we ended up in a load of thistles. Hi guys, so we're just coming over another stile here, just past Hittersley, just dropping down the stile and yeah, have to cross the railway line. So it's telling me, stop, look, listen, beware of the trains. I look both ways. There is a squirrel up there. Yeah. Cross over. Here we go. And we're now going to head back, we're going to head down that way. Over another stile. See you later. Right, evening guys, as we've just gone up to 7 o'clock and we have arrived at Mortchard Bishop. Hello guys.
Well, you got to plan it first. Yes, right. Get it right.
Evening guys, we have made it to Mortchard Bishop. Don't stop that. Yeah, it's just gone 7 o'clock. It's been a tough old day in this sun. But yeah, we've managed to get to Beech Hill House campsite. So we're pitched up here at the for the evening. And yeah, we're just gonna get some food on the go and get ready. Probably just fall asleep because we're knackered. But yeah, I'll bring you back on day 6 tomorrow from what is it? Mortchard Bishop. That's it. Mortchard. Mortchard Bishop, isn't it? Yeah. Sorry, I am knackered. But yeah, I'll bring you back tomorrow morning from Mortchard Bishop. That's it. Anyway, take it easy. Cheers. Right, morning all. It is day 6, just starting off from Beech Hill House at Mortchard Bishop. Yeah, we've had a lovely stay tonight, last night. Yeah, really lovely place. Well worth visiting if you're in the area or need somewhere to camp. Yeah. Really self-sufficient place. Environmental friendly. So yeah. But yeah, we're going to head down the road and meet up with the trail again. Right. I'll catch you guys later on. Further up. I did think you had stopped. I was about to stop recording. Yeah, so we're just coming up to Whitbridge. Gonna see if we can find somewhere to have some lunch or a late breakfast. Be nice to have a fry up. I haven't had a fry up on this trip yet. But yeah. I'll see you guys later on. Right guys, just come out of Whitbridge, filled up on some supplies. A nice cafe stop, and yeah, we're now heading on the Two Moors Way. Oh, I've got a cinnamon bun as well. So yeah, we're going to try and aim for somewhere around Alston, and I'll bring you back further along. It's about 7 miles. Take care. Cheers. We're about a mile off from being at Knollstone. There's a pub there, which we know that's there. Yeah, and then we get ourselves a drink, hopefully. And find out where we're gonna be camping tonight. Anyway, I'm gonna catch you guys a lot later on because my battery's getting low. Cheers. Hi guys, so we're in Knollstone now. That there is the Mason Arms. Sadly it's closed because we're a little bit probably too early. That is the church. There is always on churches, there's normally a water source. So there's normally a tap. So we filled up our water bottles. Got my 2 litre bag filled up. Yeah, we're gonna come out of this village and hopefully find somewhere to wild camp. I'll catch you back later on. Oh, and we've just crossed over mile 80. So it's day 6 and mile 80, which I think that's pretty brilliant. But yeah, been alright. Feet are holding up alright. So I'll catch you guys later on. Cheers. Right, evening all. It's the end of day 6. We have done a total of 82 miles. Today was 18 miles we had done, so that's pretty good. We're just in Yeomil, or Yeomil, at the Partridge Arms Farm. So yeah, we're just there. We asked kindly for permission, and they've allowed us to stay on one of their paddocks, so it's really nice little area. Yeah, so we're enjoying that at the moment. I've had tea, I've had another coffee and a hot chocolate, and I say it's just coming up to 9 o'clock and we're going to head off in a minute to sleep. We're going to try and get up early at about 5 tomorrow and leave by about 6:30 at the latest, really, because we want to try about 17 miles and get to Simmons Bath, because I think I'm gonna have to check when I get some internet signal,
that there may be a bunkhouse or somewhere near there. So that's where we're going to aim for. So we'll be heading up onto Dartmoor first thing in the morning. I mean, not Dartmoor, Exmoor in the morning. And we should see Peter Randall's upper half of the sculpture. But anyway, I'll catch you guys in the morning. Cheers for now. Bye.
Right, morning all. I said it is day 7. And yes, we've just come out of West Astery up onto Exmoor. And we've come across the second half of Peter Randall Page is Dartmoor, Tumor's sculpture. So this is the second half, which branches between the start of Exmoor and the end of Dartmoor and connects them both together. Yeah. But yeah, this one's a lot cleaner and is very nice. But anyway, we're gonna head up onto Exmoor now. There's a sign just back from the sculpture that says we have about 24 miles to go. So yeah, we're doing well. And we should be in Simmons Bath by this afternoon. All right, catch you guys later on. Cheers. Right guys, I'll bring you back. We are at Tar Steps. Just look at that. Now that is a long clapper bridge. One of the longest, I think. Yeah, it's one of the highlights of a trip. Wanted to see this one for a while, actually. Yeah. Brilliant. Ooh, they are loose as well. I love it. Yeah, I've been wanting to get to this point for a long time. Brilliant. Whoa. Yeah, as long as I don't fall in. Anyway, we're gonna head back up that way. I'll catch you guys later on. Cheers. Just amazing. Right guys, so we've just had ourselves a nice meal at the Royal Oak in Willypool. Had a nice southern burger, had some chips and some onion rings, pint of ale, and whilst the weather sort of settled down, I said we could have quite a wet night, and we're heading towards Simmons Bath. So we got another 6 miles really. Then we're just gonna have to find somewhere to camp. And in the morning, we'll be Lynmouth. Leaving us Steve in the background. I'm not by myself. There he is. But yeah, I said we should be left with about 10 miles to mull.
probably just under, because we're going to have to walk past Simmons Bath and find a spot. Anyway, I'll catch you guys a lot later on, once we're closer or even set up. Cheers. Bye. It is the end of day 7. It's gone. It's gone 7 o'clock now, isn't it? Ah, so it's 8:30 now. We've set up just under 6 miles from the finish line. We were thinking about going further, but we've basically found a nice little spot, 102 miles in. So we've done 20 miles today, so that's enough for today. We'll finish up early tomorrow, and we'll see you down there. Take care, and I'll see you in the morning on day 8. Cheers. Morning, guys. I said it's just gone 7 o'clock. I said we just packed up, just checking the area over, making sure we leave no trace. It was an all right night. The rain came down hard, and the wind did whip through, but we knew that anyway. It was going to do that, so it wasn't too bad really. The Lunar Solo held up well. So that's good. Yeah, so it wasn't a bad night really. Slightly pitched on a slope, so every so often would slide down about 1/2 foot, and then I would have to sort myself out. But yeah, but I slept well anyway. Feel all right actually. Yeah, we just filled our water bottles up, and we've got about 6 miles left to the finish at Lynmouth. So I'll see you en route. Cheers. Morning, guys. We've just come through the top of Exmoor. The rain has started. We've got about 3.5-4 miles left until we hit Lynmouth. So yeah, we're getting there. Just walking along this valley now. It's good because gives a little bit of cover from the rain. Yeah, all going well. Until I fall over. But yeah, I'll see you further along. Cheers. 2.5 to the end, Steve.
How far?
2.5.
Really?
Yeah.
What are we going to do when we get to the end, mate? I mean, we've had such an epic journey.
I think we have to think about turning around and going back the other way.
Well, I have got another week off.
Have you?
Do you reckon?
Yeah, could do, couldn't we?
Yeah, we could. We'll give it some thought.
Yeah, we will. Yeah, we'll think about it. Yeah.
Think about it.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. All right, man. Yeah, doing well. Just climbed out of Waters Meet, and the sign said back there says 2.5 miles to Lynmouth. It's actually less than that. The signs can be wrong, which I found out quite a lot along this route really. But I'll go through that with more detail in my debrief after these videos come out. Yeah. That will take you back to Waters Meet, where we came from. A bit of a circular, and that's where we're heading. Lynmouth, follow that. Let's go. Right, you can actually see the sea down there, past the sign saying
1.5 to Lynmouth. So we are getting there. Check that out. It's just going into the sun. Yeah, we were up that way this morning. Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, so just down there, you've got Lynmouth. Up top here is Linton. And we'll be down there shortly. Probably in the next half hour or so. Just a gorgeous day. And my walking companion, Steve, Dartmoor Wanderer. So yeah, if you enjoy watching my videos, go out and check out his channel. It's been a great 8 days with you, Steve. And yeah, looked forward to more trips. Anyway, I'm gonna carry on walking. Right, guys, we're just walking down. Oh, you're right.
Oh, I slid a long way in.
Oh. Almost didn't make it.
Broke your leg on the last
100 yards. Yeah, it's fucking a bit greasy down here.
A bit greasy.
Yeah, just a bit. Anyway, I was just saying, we're just walking down to Lynmouth Harbour, where we'll find the end of the Devon coast to coast. Right, bring you back in a minute. Yeah, so we're just walking to the end point. We'll sign the register book. Cracking day. Oh, Steve, look at that sign, eh?
Hey?
Look at that sign.
Yeah.
You know, 2 miles way, Wembury, 117 miles. Sounds good, doesn't it?
It does, doesn't it? So, what do you think you're doing now?
Well, I'm thinking, why don't we go again?
Should we walk it back?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Let's go do it.
Go for it.
So, Steve, what happened to going the other way?
Well, I think we're just refueling at the moment.
Oh, okay, that's all right.
And, yeah, I mean, it's only, what is it, 11 o'clockish?
Yeah.
Yeah, 10 past 11, so it was half hour, mate.
Yeah, we should be fueled up.
Back up here.
Yeah.
Onward bound. Save the bus fare. Walk home.
Yeah.
Cool. See you on the trail.
Take care, guys.
Cheers, bye-bye.
Thanks for watching.